Hi all, welcome to this lecture on The Shape of the Soul, a short story prescribed for semester 2 undergraduate programs in the Mahatma Gandhi University and especially CMS College Kottayam Autonomous. As an introduction, let's have a look at a few places on the world map. Here we have the Latin American countries, which are places in and near the South American continent. These places were colonies of Spain and Portugal. Even after the colonial period, they used Spanish or Portuguese languages, which are two languages that originated from the Latin language, and hence these countries are called Latin American countries. These are the countries marked as the Latin American. And for this study, we focus on three of them. Argentina, a Latin American country where our author is born. Then we have Uruguay, a Latin American country near Argentina. Our story starts from Uruguay, and Brazil, which is the largest Latin American country, this finds a mention in our story. Our next focus is on a group of islands in Europe, on the western part of Europe, known as the British Isles. Here we concentrate on two countries. One is England, a country which is part of the British Isles, and also Ireland, another country in the British Isles. Part of our story happens here in Ireland. We need to understand a bit of history as well, along with the geography, to get a better idea of the story. So, the Irish War of Independence. In 1801, Ireland became part of the United Kingdom, which also had England, Scotland and Wales in it. Later, the Irish Republicans tried to break away from the Union. This resulted in the Irish War of Independence from 1919 to 1921. Even though the war formally entered in 1921, there were occasional fights which spread into 1922. And our story has this point of reference, 1922 in Ireland. The story is brought to us by Jorge Luis Borges, born in Argentina. Shortly after his birth, his family relocated to a place known as Palermo. In those days, this place was known for its loose and criminal background. And the author grew up amid stories of knife fights and violence, images which were to find reflections in his writings, as we do find it in our story as well. His father was a lawyer and a psychology teacher, and his mother was descended from a long line of soldiers and freedom fighters. Her own mother had furnished their home with family artifacts such as swords, uniforms, and portraits of great freedom fighters. Borges was terribly fond of both his parents. The story is originally written in the Spanish language. It is translated to English by scholar Andrew Hurley. Let's have a look at the characters. We have three main characters in the story. There is the narrator, who is Borges himself. This is made clear towards the end of the story when one character addressed the narrator. "To you alone, Borges, I have made this confession." Then we have the second person, the Englishman at La Colorada. Actually, he is not an Englishman. He is not from England, but he is an Irishman from Ireland. The third person, John Vincent Moon, is introduced to us through the story told to the narrator. The story design. The shape of the sword happens in two places. We have a description first by Borges, who speaks of another person, the Englishman at La Colorada. One day, while talking, Borges asks him of the scar on his face. On his face, from one side of the temple, on his forehead, we have a moon-shaped scar going to his cheek. So Borges asks about the scar. This brings out from him a story that happens in Ireland. Through the story, we are introduced to John Vincent Moore.